It's the latest ImACeleb evicted. Please welcome Dom. Hi, Dom. I mean, well, there's a lot there to unpack, isn't there? But before we get into all the drama, let's talk about the fact that you're eliminated, because you have, I understand, a huge following on what they call the social medias. And I understand that that means you would get a lot of votes. How did you end up here?
Yeah, oh, look, that's the name of the game. I think it's anyone's game at this point, really. Everyone in camp right now is in with a huge chance to win. I think Australia has fallen in love with every single person in camp this year, so it's very hard, and I'm just blessed that I got to spend 25 days in the jungle with some amazing people, and now I can get out and eat all the Vegemite on toast I want.
Hey, Dom, the show really put you through it, though, right? Because you went through some really tough challenges, including that Viper room. How did you keep you cool?
Yeah, the Viper room, whilst being iconic, it was absolutely terrifying. I don't know what was the worst part. It was either being buried in corn, which took 9 minutes to fill up, or the fact that there were 65 snakes all around me. Some of them were peeing, others were hissing in my ears. My only thoughts were just stay as still as possible, because if I moved or looked frightened, I thought that they would strike and bite me in the face. And, I can't have anything happen to this moneymaker.
Sorry, did you just say you didn't know what the bad bit was, the snakes or the corn?
Yeah, and that's when you know it's really bad. Well, I was in that thing, I could not move my arms, and I was buried in corn. And I actually took corn back to camp in my pockets, and they cooked it up and made popcorn and ate it, even though it had snake piss on it.
Hey, Dom, let's talk about CAC. That was a pretty big Barney with the Aussie Queen of TV. As a viewer, it was quite uncomfortable to watch, but talk us through it. Do you regret at all what you said?
Yeah, look, my choice of language wasn't great, and I do sincerely regret my way of articulating during that conversation, but I don't take back how I felt. In the moment, it was really tense, it was frustrating. We're all starving back at camp, and to see someone just blatantly not want to participate was really disheartening. And you know, we're all starving, and in the jungle you have to be selfless. So for me to see that power imbalance and to see someone that didn't even want to give it a go, it was really frustrating, and I kind of just let loose. And it was unfortunate that it kind of ended that way, but, I think apparently I've heard that the Revlon 1989 lipstick has gone up in sales. So if anything, Revlon's happy. They've come out of administration, and I think the world can go on.
Any chance that you and Kerri-Anne might catch up for a wine after this is all over?
Oh, look, more than happy to catch up with CAC. The wine's on me, Kerri-Anne. Yes, I do make money out of doing Instagram for a living. So more than happy to come and drive out from the inner west to come to Woollahra to meet your CAC for a wine. On me.
Well, Dom, you also channeled early 2000s Australian Idol and disagreed with the outspoken Dicko. Do you think you met your match with him?
Oh, Dicko's got nothing on me. Look, he's at the back end of a long, illustrious career, and I don't know what he came on here for, but I think he met his match with me, actually. Dicko and I had a brilliant relationship. It really reminded me of me and my dad, and it was nice that we could kind of have those tiffs, but at the end of the day, we'd come together and we got through whatever was thrown at us. So I'm looking forward to catching up with Dicko and seeing him after I get home.
There were also some lovely moments with you and other, what do we call you, campmates, I guess. Who are you going to miss the most?
Oh, look, I'm really going to miss your very own Peter Hellyer. He would come in every night and be the sheriff. He'd have his Akubra on, and he'd had his little whip to try and mimic the honey badger, and he'd do a comedy routine every night to bring up the spirits if we only had a few stars and we were all starving going to bed. So I'm really going to miss Pete, but every single person in there I've made an incredible friendship with, and I can't wait to continue that on the outside.
Let us know how that catch-up with CAC goes. But in the meantime, to catch more jungle action, ImACeleb will be back tonight right after us. Domenica, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me.